Hello children, welcome to my class. In today's class, you will be learning about a new chapter, Microorganisms, Friend and Foe. What are microorganisms? You have seen several kinds of plants and animals. However, there are other living organisms around us which we normally cannot see. These are called microorganisms or microbes. You might have observed during rainy season, the moist bread and coconut get spoiled and its surface gets covered with grayish white patches. When you observe these patches through a magnifying lens, you will see tiny black rounded structures. Do you know what these structures are and where do these come from? These microorganisms are so small in size that they cannot be seen with the unaided eye. But some of these, such as fungus that grow on bread, can be seen with a magnifying glass. Others cannot be seen without the help of a microscope. That is why these are called microorganisms or microbes. Microorganisms are classified into four major groups. These groups are bacteria, fungi, protozoa, and some algae. Viruses are also microscopic, but are different from other microorganisms. Viruses reproduce only inside the cells of the host organism. The host may be a bacterium, plant, animal, or human being. Common diseases caused by viruses are common cold, flu, and cough. Serious diseases like polio and chickenpox are also caused by viruses. Diseases like dysentery and malaria are caused by protozoans. Whereas typhoid and tuberculosis are bacterial diseases. Where do microorganisms live? They live in all types of environment, ranging from ice-cold climate to hot springs and deserts to marshy lands. They are also found inside the bodies of animals, including human beings. Microorganisms play an important role in our lives. Some of them are beneficial in many ways, whereas some others are harmful and cause diseases. Let us study how microorganisms can be friendly and foe in detail. Microorganisms are used for various purposes. They are used in the preparation of curd, bread, and cake. They are also used in the cleaning up of environment. For example, the organic waste, vegetable peels, remains of animals are broken down into harmless and usable substances by bacteria. In agriculture, they are used to increase soil fertility by fixing atmospheric nitrogen. You have learnt in your previous class that milk is turned into curd by bacteria. Curd contains several microorganisms. Out of these, the bacterium Lactobacillus promotes the formation of curd. It multiplies in the milk and converts it into curd. Bacteria are also involved in the making of cheese, pickles, and many more food items. Bacteria and yeast are also helpful for the fermentation of idlis and dosa batter. Yeast reproduces rapidly and produces carbon dioxide during the respiration. Bubbles of the gas fill the dough and increase its volume. This is the basis of the use of yeast in the baking industry for making breads, pastries, and cakes. In the next class, you will be learning about some more uses of microorganisms.